Hello and welcome back to the new part modeling tutorial. In this video, we'll design this part. This is the drawing of the part. Let's start our tutorial. First, I'm going to design this portion in the front view. Define sketch. Select this plane or YZ plane. Position sketch. Okay. Select profile command, create a profile, now give the dimensions, right click, allow symmetry, select horizontal axis. Change these values as per the drawing. This length is 80 mm, so it is a diameter. And this side is 40, angle is 45, width is 75. 80, this one is a 40, width is 75, this angle is 45, exit workbench. Now I'm going to create which is visible in the right view, means these two circles. First I'm creating this 80 mm diameter circle. Select this right side plane, means ZX plane, position sketch, okay. Select a circle, create circle from center point and give the dimensions. This diameter is 80 mm. Exit workbench. Define part body. The sketch pacer feature, select solid command, select sketch 1 and sketch 2, preview and OK. Now I'm going to create this feature. Select this left side plane, means YZ plane, position sketch, OK. Select profile command, create a vertical line and select this tangent arc, create a arc, again vertical line and close this sketch and give the dimensions, vertical axis and this vertical line. This radius, select this point and horizontal axis, select this horizontal line and horizontal axis, here you can see there is one symbol V and here is H. But in this line, there is no any symbol. It's mean this line is not fully constrained. So select this line, right click, go to object, select vertical. Now it's turned to green color. So it is fully constrained. Now change the values. Radius is 12.5, vertical length is 42.5 and this length is 7.5 mm. This one is 42.5, this is 7.5, this radius is 12.5 and this length is not given, it is approximate. This vertical length is not given in this drawing because it is constraints to this profile, I mean this edge. This diameter is 45 mm, it is half of this length. So it should be 45 by 2, this is 22.5 mm. Exit workbench. Define part body. This pad length is 65 mm. Select sketch 3. Go to pad option. Select mirror extend 65 by 2. Preview. It is 32.5 mm. Okay. Define part body. Now I'm going to create this counterbore hole feature. This diameter is 15 and depth is 8 mm. Through diameter is 9. Go to hole feature. Select this face. Click on position sketch. Constrain this point. Select this point and this arc. Right click, concentricity, exit workbench. In the old definition, go to type, change simple to counterbore. Counterbore diameter is 15 mm, depth is 8 mm. Preview, go to extension, through hole diameter is 9 mm. Change blind to up to next or up to last. Review and OK. This is the counterbore feature. Define sketch. Now I'm going to create this slot feature and inner hole. This diameter is 45 mm. This slot is 3 mm. Select this right side plane, means ZX plane. Position sketch. Okay. Select circle. Create a circle from center point. This diameter is 45 mm. Select profile command. Create vertical line, horizontal and vertical. This sketch will be closed. Press escape or press this icon. Select quick trim command. Trim this unwanted line. Constrain this profile. Select both vertical lines. Right click, allow symmetry. Select vertical axis. In the operation command bar, select this project 3D shell out edges command. Select this top face. Select this projected line and convert this line as a construction. Select horizontal line and projected line. Right click, coincidence. Select this horizontal line. This thickness, I mean this length is 3 mm. Our sketch is fully constrained. Check the status. It is ISO, means it is fully constrained. Exit workbench. Define the part body. Select edge fillet. Select this edge. This radius is 12 mm. Again select edge fillet. Select this outer edge. This radius is 5 mm. Define part body. Select sketch 6. Select pocket command. Reverse direction. Change type to up to last or up to next. Preview and OK. Now give the edge fillets. Select edge fillet. Select this vertical edges. Radius is 2 mm. Review. Okay. can select these edges. Preview. Okay. Now select this inner edge. This radius is 5 mm. Preview and okay. Our part design is completed. If you have any doubt, please be comment in this video. Thank you for watching.